Today, let us see what is a token in Java. If you have ever gone to a office to get your work done or to a bank, you may have noticed that if there is a queue, you get a token so that you can remember which number you have been allotted. Mostly this happens even in the clinics. If you go to a clinic, then you will get a token, and when your number comes, then you will be called. So that particular receipt is called a token. So token, a receipt can be called a token, or if you have a gift voucher or a gift hamper, that is also called a token. In English language, there are several different meanings of token. Token is used in literary terms in different ways. But in Java, we are going to see what a token is. The definition of token is, token is the smallest unit of code, smallest unit of code of Java, which the Java compiler can identify and process. So let us see a small example. A is equal to B plus C. Here A is a variable or an identifier. A, B and C, all three are variables. Equals to is the assignment operator. Plus is the addition operator. And semicolon is a punctuator. So these are all part of the character set of Java. Why are we calling it token? Because the classification here is made for the sake of the compiler. When you write a program, it will be compiled in a software called a compiler. So for the compiler to understand what is being sent into it, the classification is done. That classification is called tokens. Token is the smallest unit that the compiler can identify and process. So in the definition of token, there are different words. It is a smallest unit or it is a single element. Let us say we have a code of program, and in that code, A is an element, equals to is an element, B is an element, then token is a single element. Single element is a token. Or we can say smallest meaningful unit. Smallest meaningful unit which the compiler can understand. Tokens are nothing but Java's character set, the elements of Java character set for the sake of compiler. Let us see definition of token. Token is the smallest unit of code which the Java compiler can identify and process. So all the different tokens are nothing but the Java character set. There are literals or constants, there are identifiers or variables, there are assignments, punctuators, separators and keywords. Now let us see all these different types of tokens in detail. Now let us see what are the literals or constants as tokens. This is the classification of literals or constants. There are integer literals, real literals, character literals, string literals, boolean literals and a null literal. Integer literals are the integers. For example, 1, 9, 22, minus 35. They can be positive or negative both. Real literals are those which use a decimal point in the number. For example, 22.5, minus 36.2. These are real literals. Then we see character literals. Character literals are written in single quotes. For example, single quote A, single quote B. You can use capital letters, small letters. Also, you can use numbers. Even if you write a number inside single quotes, that becomes a character literal. It is not treated as a number, but it is treated as a character literal. And you can also print special symbols if you use single quotes. So these are all called character literals. Then there are string literals. For writing string literals, we use double quotes. If I write BlueJ in double quote, it becomes a string literal. If I write year 2020 inside a double quote, it becomes a string literal. Then we have Boolean literals. There are only two Boolean literals, true and false. It is not written inside any quote. True and false are Boolean literals. Then we have null literals. Backslash zero. It is not O, it is zero. Backslash zero in single quotes is called a string terminator. So these are all tokens in Java. These are literals or constants. In the next video, we'll learn about variables.